what are like brand partners looking for, you know, in terms of obviously the big thing with Bleacher Report is creating killer branding content, Jack Links, PlayStation, all these guys pay buku bucks to be on something like this.
Well, thank you for saying that. Yeah, I think, you know, the shift in the industry has gone from adjacency and being close to the content that we produce to brands really looking for a point of view and a way to create and collaborate on original content, right? More and more brands, they don't want to become brand publishers, but they do want to create with the brands that are creating the best stuff. And so I think the value proposition that's winning with us, with brands, is the ability to sit at the table together, share insights and analytics of what's working for our editorial team, what's working for our brand on and resonating socially, and applying that to the challenges that they have in their marketing capabilities. You know, I do see that the world of social has become even more fragmented, and you have to speak in a different language on different platforms. And I think that's only going to become more and more apparent, right? Like, people are going to start to go to the different social platforms. They're going to start working in augmented reality and virtual reality. And you just have to understand how to talk to those folks in those different languages. You know, you think about the way that your brand is and how it's presented the same way that a human being would, right? So your LinkedIn profile is probably not the same content that your Snapchat profile is. If it is, you probably either have a pretty boring Snapchat channel or an extremely lit LinkedIn channel.
Which might work out pretty well nowadays.
Yeah.
And then in branded content, is there a platform that you see that people want to be on it? Where are your resources in terms of directing and producing some type of branded content headed in the next year or so?
I'm bullish on all of the social platforms. I think you need to be able to have high energy in each one of them and understand them all. And again, not all content works on each one. Instagram for us is the one that's the most exciting and the most riveting. It feels like the new water cooler, right? It feels like the place that people are coming to, whether it's an hour after or 24 hours after, to talk about those moments. And what's fun about this water cooler, especially on our House of Highlights handle, is LeBron James and Kyrie Irving are joining that water cooler and giving their feedback and putting eyeball emojis there and keeping on and carrying on that conversation.
With the House of Highlights, how important do you think that is and as you go forward into 2018 and what they've done and what Omar's done and bringing them on board? You know, what's the importance of that?
Oh, it's just so fun, right? It's such a new level of energy all across Bleacher Report to just like get back to celebrating the core essence of what sports are, which is just having fun with your friends and competing and going out there with a smile on your face. It's playing a pretty important strategy for us because as Bleacher Report grows and matures, we want to identify the next generation of fans and what they care about and what they're looking for. And House of Highlights just taps into that cultural zeitgeist so much and just embraces what all fans are craving, which is just a fun, happy time.
And with the influence of the athletes and the fact that you're owned by Turner, what is your spot at the culture and where the NBA is going and where you guys are going?
All of sports has gone from leagues and teams to players and personalities, and the NBA is the best at that, right? So to be a collaborative and cooperative partner with NBA on TNT is just super fun. You know, about 98% of a professional player's life is not spent on the court, and more people are starting to care about who is going to the Milan fashion show, who's talking to who on Instagram, how does that lead into it? One of my favorite examples of this just recently, the Lakers-Knicks game. Lonzo Ball walks into the locker room wearing a shirt from Nas's Illmatic album, but his face on top of it. That referenced something that he said 3 or 4 weeks ago, where he said kids his age don't listen to Nas and don't know about New York rap. So he was actively trolling the New York market, but he was doing it in a way that heightened the excitement and heightened the conversation and brought a new level of fandom to the game.
And obviously those players and personalities are playing right into what you're doing and what you're creating around.
Yeah, and they just get it, you know? They're having fun. They know that being recognizable is not the end game. It's having those personal connections that are gonna reinforce the relationships with their fans.
Do you think a presence and what you guys have done at Bleacher Report to interject yourself in those conversations has helped spur them even further to wanna be some of these people?
Yeah, I hope so. Cam Newton was asked after the Panthers game if he saw the most recent episode of Gridiron Heights, and he was like, no, I haven't, but I'm really excited. I watched last week's, what did they say about me? And he was like, all right, I'm gonna go watch it. That's really fun to see that the athletes, you know, are part of this culture, right? And that reinforces back to the fans that, you know, they get it and they're having fun with that. They're having fun with their personalities. They're having fun with the jokes that are being made about them. They're not taking themselves too seriously. That absolutely has helped fuel this.
Perfect. Do you want to do some shoot arounds and we'll talk some stats and stuff like that? I think it'd be cool.
Yeah, let's try it.
What are the metrics you guys are looking at? What are the metrics your partners are looking at? Yeah. You know, where do you want to be?
Yeah, great question. I think for us, the thing that we care most about is something we call real engagement, right? We look at all the companies that have grown scale for scale's sake, and we realize that scale without engagement really means nothing. It's like having an empty stadium that you can fill 100,000 seats in. If they're quiet, there's nothing really going on. We want to be loud and resonant with our audience. So we look at that stat, right? And that comes across with social video. Not just the view metric, because that's really important, but what are people doing after that view? Do we create something that compels them to at mention their friends, to share it in a different feed, to take it and post it on their wall? What is it that happens after that? Because that's what's really driving the interaction.
Pivot to video, pivot to writing. Where's your stance? Where are you at? Is it a mix of both? Does writing still do really well?
Yeah, I think, you know, it is such a hot topic. And I think what we've done is right. Continue to pivot towards quality, right? Embrace the quality that we're creating and continue to do that, whether it's text, whether it's display imagery, whether it's creating original video, whether it's creating original animation. Tell the best story in the best medium possible and the fans will come to it.
Cool.
Just like nail one more J and feel good about it.
Oh. Did you get that? Yeah. Crushed it. Let's take a quick walk and we'll talk about the future. So obviously 2017 in the window, maybe in the past, 2018's coming. What's the future for Bleacher Report? Where do we go from here? 5 years, 10 years? What are you guys looking at?
Yeah, so the future is doubling down on our original content. It's kind of leveling up, right? We want to break through the ceiling of original content and create something that's even more premium. As Jermaine, our head of the editorial side, says, content that sticks to the bone. Things that people are going to remember that will stop the internet, right? We live in a society that people just scroll through everything. We want to create 20 to 30 pieces of original content next year that are just going to stop people in their tracks and shake up the internet and get people talking about sports culture in a different way.
And how do you do that?
We dig in. Great original reporting, ridiculously smart, creative comedy writers, fresh perspectives, diverse talent. We're just going to double down on the great intellect that's in this room. And get them to think about things and push those needle forward.